Well, I'm very proud to tell you that Latest TV was involved with saving the lives of pigeons in the city. And with me are charity worker Theo Williams and Smudge the pigeon to talk about that and about some other related topics. So welcome you two.
Thank you.
Theo, last time you came here, you were talking about the sort of cruel netting that some pigeons have been trapped in the city.
Yeah.
And as a result, you were contacted by a lady in Brighton who witnessed a similar thing, and you kind of helped sort the situation. Do you want to briefly go through that?
Yeah, well, one of my previous interview was aired a couple of weeks ago, and a lady, through watching that, brought my attention to, in one of the parks, there's some derelict buildings, and there was netting, there was trapping lots of pigeons where they can get in, but they can't get out again. And that had been going on for months. And she tried to contact the RSPCA and the police and other agencies, but because of the times they were in, it wasn't classed as an emergency, so she didn't know what else to do. And then when she saw your TV show featuring myself and Mark, she got in touch with me through that, and I was able to gain access and remove most of the netting.
Right.
It was an empty derelict building. We couldn't find the key holder.
Right.
And in certain cases, if animals are suffering, I've got the power to do that, the same as the RSPCA.
Sure.
So
okay.
It's as a direct result of Latest TV, scores and scores of pigeons have been saved and will continue to be saved that would have perished.
So
this year.
Yeah, I'm really pleased to hear about that.
Yeah.
I'd like you to tell me a little bit about your work in general. So you run the charity, really, Pigeon Rescue in Brighton.
Yeah.
What do you do, and how do people contact you?
Well, I've been doing it for about 5 years. I've got a website, which is pigeonrescuebrighton@wordpress.com, and that's how people contact me. So on the website is email and two phone numbers, and then people phone up and they either bring the birds to me or I go to them and collect them.
And what we're talking about, injured birds?
Yeah, birds, mostly that, especially this time of year in the summer, they've fallen out of the nest. So they've fallen out for some reason, only a couple of weeks old. They get mobbed by magpies and other birds and they wouldn't survive. So people pick them up, normally from in their own gardens, and then they contact me and then I'll continue to raise them for another few weeks and then I'll move them on to bigger agencies that have got more provisions than me.
Right. And Smudge there, who looks very snug, actually, you've had him since he was inside an egg, right?
Well, I've raised him from an egg, yes.
You've raised him from an egg?
Yeah.
So he's a proper pet in a way.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you said he was a little bit nervous today, but he actually seems quite calm.
He's calmed down now, yeah.
Right.
But he's imprinted, you see. So if you raise them from an egg and you just, they become imprinted, so they become humanised. So they have to go for what's called a soft release. So he'll go, in a couple of months probably or less, he will go to another agency, it's a place called Barbecues in Bexhill. It's like an animal sanctuary and it's a farm. And they've got great big outdoor aviaries for pigeons. And then they get fed there and watered and then there's a hatch so they can go into the wild or they can stay.
Right.
And that's called a soft release.
Right.
So it gets them used to the climate and the weather and the cold nights.
So it's a gradual release, yeah.
And a hard release would be if you just took them into a field and just let them go.
Okay.
I'll try and go for a soft release.
And obviously you are very attached to the pigeons, to the work that you do.
Yeah.
What would you say to people, and a lot of people do say, they're only vermin, you know, they're nuisance, they litter the place.
Well, everyone's entitled to their opinion, of course, and no one likes the same animals. But I'd remind people that they're very intelligent, they're very loving, as you can see, and that they're actually one of the most intelligent birds on the planet, if not the most intelligent.
Really?
They can recognise faces, they can recognise people, even if you're wearing different clothes, for people that feed them, that they recognise them, indeed myself, and also...
They were used in the war, weren't they?
They were used in the war, I was just going to come to that. And they helped save lives in World War I and World War II. They used to tie messages to their legs, send them across from England. They'd go to occupied France or Belgium, and then the civilians there would pick them up, write messages about the enemy, and then they would fly back. Whereas normally, if a human did that, they'd have spies, and it would take a week or 2 weeks for the information to come back to the UK. But with pigeons, it would come back within 12 to 24 hours.
And wouldn't draw so much attention.
So
there you go. The humble pigeon saved a lot of lives in the past and you're saving their lives now. Thank you so much for coming to the studio.
Oh, thank you.